so much of that game. All right, we're into picks and bans. These are two teams that are really desperate and hungry for wins. In the bottom half of the table, Ryze, Gangplank taken away, Kalista out, so Lucian, Corki, Poppy. You know, those power picks that we're seeing time and time again. Where do you think the priority lies?
Well, it's funny because Roccat are pretty much the only team that people are banning Ryze against still. And it's just because Betsy is having a decent time in the mid lane. We've had a few good games from him. But you look at this pick and ban phase, and there are still a lot of high priority picks still available. Corki is still up. Poppy is still up. The Alistar is now not available, as that is the final ban coming out from Roccat. Lucian is up, so now we're in the situation. Is it the Corki trade for the flex pick first, or do you go for that safe bottom lane? Elements will prioritize their bot lane.
Well, that's a good pick, I feel, for Mr. Rawls. He's been good, but he's not been game-changing for Elements this split. And denying a top-tier pick maybe from Tabs or one of them,
I mean, that's the real confusion about Elements, because they were at a point where they were at 3-1. MRRallez got MVP. SPRATTEL was on the OP5 list on week 2. And then they started facing tougher opponents. And the elements that we saw weeks 1 and 2 just did not appear. And they've just gone loss after loss after loss. And they're at 3-6 now. It's not the same team that we looked at the end of week 1 and 2 and were like, wow, okay, Elements are actually surprising us.
Yeah, and for Elements, luckily now the split is reset. So they beat the teams below them. They lost the teams above them, and now Elements are playing a squad that is quite far away. Roccat struggled yesterday. They lost to Giants, and they've now locked in the Corki-Braum combo.
One thing Roccat will have is the ability to counterpick, obviously being on the red side. The key thing on this one is EIKA is a player who has typically, for Elements, been playing control mages. He's played a lot of Viktor, Morgana. He has had that game on Ryze that he did okay on. But it means that Roccat won't really get that favorable a matchup unless they got something that's hidden up their sleeves. They may look to give Fredy the better matchup in the top lane. Now they can see the Poppy's being locked in. That kind of zones away the option that we've seen. In fact, looking at it, they could do the Quinn that Freddy's been playing.
Oh, I hope not, because he doesn't really know how to split push on that champion.
Right, but this is a matchup that is favorable for Fredy if he looks to go for it. Now, as you alluded to, his performance yesterday on the Quinn wasn't so great. So this is kind of one of those situations for Elements where they could be about to make a big mistake if they're banking on Fredy not being able to perform quite as well.
Well, let's see what they decide to lock in. Fredy's got the options to counterpick. And in the last few seconds, secure most likely this Kindred for Airwaks. Rek'Sai is off the table, as is Nidalee. Elise is there, but Kindred has been played twice already and is somewhat of a comfort pick here for Airwaks, and it will get locked in. The Lulu to follow. So Betsy's played that once. We've not seen it in Freddy's hands. I don't associate it with Fredy, but it could go either way.
So much flex here, though. You've got the Corki could be mid, the Lulu could be mid, the Kindred could be AD carry, the Corki could be the AD carry. There is so much. Could even be in a situation, I highly doubt this, by the way, but we could even have a Lulu top lane that we haven't seen all that much of recently. So Elements really are kind of trying to piece together Roccat's composition. At this point, for the likes of Roccat, having Betsy on that Lulu, I wonder, he has been the one player that Roccat have been able to get behind. Is this enough presence coming from their middle lane? That's kind of a problem in my mind right now.
Well, we do see Elements lock in their final champions. It is Elise plus Viktor. And with all of the disengage and the support of Peel and abilities here, Kindred, Lulu, Janna, wave clear for days, we could be in for a long one.
Well, we just heard Gilius talk about early game junglers being aggressive. Elise will do that. The problem is with a Kindred matchup, as always with Elise, it's if you hit the cocoon, you can go aggressive. If you miss that cocoon, you better back away, because Kindred is going to trade a whole lot of damage back into you. So Airwaks and Gilius could have an explosive start to the game, but as you said, I wonder whether we'll tend towards a slower, more passive game from these teams.
And I also feel unless everybody's perfectly positioned, Wild Growth, Lamb's Respite, Monsoon, you've got all these tools to help deal at least with some of the catches, but obviously not an absolute all-in.
So, does Roccat go for the Quinn here and look for the split push? They will have a Lulu as well to kind of empower the Quinn later into the game. Still flex options. Wow, okay, Trundle picked up at this point. That is a...
That's top.
I mean, yeah, top lane if it goes up there. Normally a straight-up tank shredder with that subjugate. This is a matchup I've actually seen kind of backfire horribly. We've seen this matchup, I believe, in Challenger in week one. I have to stretch back in my mind. Trundle obviously gives Poppy extra terrain to utilize, but at the same time, you are able to disrupt very heavily with that Trundle in the top lane. That's a really bad pick by Fredy, but not one that I was expecting in this situation.
I think the theoretical approach of that pillar of ice, the disruption that it can give both a Poppy, a Viktor, a Lucian, and a frontline when combined with Braum, I think there's potential, but elements have to be on the same page. I do like the pick for Fredy, because yesterday he did not split push.
Yes.
He played Quinn, and he still stuck with his team, still looked for those team fights. He'll have more of an impact on this Trundle.
Mm-hmm. And especially with the likes of Kindred already locked in, you've already got a second AD carry threat here, but at this point, the compositions have been locked in. Show your support on Twitter, whoever you think has the better composition or whoever you want to win. Hashtag ELWin or hashtag ROCWin. And we'll get to that and see the fan vote as we get later into this game. But these are some kind of weird comps on the side of Roccat.
Yeah, a slightly different approach to the game. But when you are struggling, when you are 1-8, maybe you do have to do something a little different. We've heard the analysts talking about how Fnatic tried to enforce the meta. Let's see if Roccat can invent some of their own. The crowd is hyped for our penultimate game of week 5. The Elements logo flying high on the left, facing off against the Roccat flag. Lit up on the rift. Trollololol, lolol, lolol, is what Fredy will be singing all day.
Well, there's clearly some fans of, you know, maybe some traditional sports. We got a clacker in here today as well. I was a little bit confused. Thought someone was maybe, you know, repairing a car wheel or something, trying to turn that wrench. But no, it's not the right place to be
is
doing that.
Is that what it's called?
Studio. I don't know.
A clacker?
Probably. That's the kind of noise.
Could I go into a shop and be like, hey, I'd like to buy a clacker?
Look, let me put it this way. If you're British, you can use any word to describe anything, and somebody somewhere will understand what you mean.
I'm not quite sure that's the truth, but we'll see how it works out. Defensive starts here, Stress. Everyone lined up across the river, splashing some water at one another. And no indication of a lane swap just yet. You have to feel that this Corki Braum lane is going to get a little bit poked out maybe by the Janna Lucian early until Tabs gets access to that Rocket Barrage.
Minions
Thunderlords still on the side there for both Betsy and Tabs.
Yeah, and one of the masteries to look at for the top laners as well, obviously Grasp of the Undying. We've seen so much of it. That's another thing that will synergize fairly well with this Trundle. Of course, you know, loves to trade one versus one, will be able to drop his W, be able to get that extra healing and regeneration, Frozen Domain. So that kind of enhances his kit. Seen a lot of different top laners come from that. So now I'm wondering how Steve and Fredy will trade back and forth on that, but we can see Elements, their dual lane, have gone all the way into the deep jungle at this point to start it off. Sprattle's gonna come down, try and disrupt Fredy and Airwaks, but has to be careful. We've seen these backfire. Yesterday, Kasing was forced to flash out on Thresh when he tried to do a move like that.
And the lane swap did happen. A little later than I was anticipating, so the map has now been cut in half. Elements declaring control. The northern part, you can see Gilius already moving into the jungle with Steve. They're going to hold hands. Quadra teleports this game. Both solo laners on both teams running those TPs. So I want to see how those are going to impact the dives when they eventually start happening.
Bit of a difference on this lane swap from Elements to the, you know, most that we'll see in the LCS in general. Elements actually started on their strong side and then went straight into the enemy jungle and up to the top lane. Rather than starting on the bottom side, you could see Extinkt from Roccat was waiting, trying to get the information of when Elements were coming to red buff. Didn't actually get it, and what it means is Elements were slightly faster on the push here. You can see the rest of Roccat weren't quite there in time, and they are behind on the push itself onto the tower. Elements significantly further ahead on the damage done right now. It's all from that adaptation.
Let's see what they can do, because yesterday in the lane swap versus Fnatic, they were unable to get any real semblance of control, and it fell apart very, very quickly. Yesterday, Fnatic pushed Elements all the way to the inner turret. So tower will fall in favor of Elements and Steve, plus 345. We'll catch a glimpse down bottom. 5 to 10 seconds ahead of Roccat. And already you can see the duo lane for Elements has recalled and gonna position themselves down.
And you can see Airwaks at the same time. Obviously going in, reading that they weren't on the red buff, can take it away, means that Roccat will clear out that lower side jungle and establish some vision control in the Elements lower side jungle. So right now, depends. Elements have put their duo lane into the bottom lane, sent Poppy up top, or kept Poppy up top. Steve didn't recall yet, no presence or no threat in that lane to force him away. But this isn't the best situation for Steve right now, because he's going to be forced to recall very shortly as soon as Corki arrives. There is a ward to spot Corki out, so shouldn't actually die. But then Steve has to make the decision. Does he return to the top lane and maybe not get a whole lot of farm? Actually, Steve's stuck around here. Look at the way Braum's pathing up through the river. Steve way overstayed. I wonder whether that ward actually died. It's timed out now.
Winter's Bite, Exhaust as well. A Valk Ford. Airwaks has flashed, but he's not on the same page. Wastes his flash, trying to follow. Steve Tabzz had backed away and opts to farm instead.
That ward did spot out Tabzz as well, so Steve was just banking on the fact that it was only Corki that was coming top. That flash now not going to be available. Not the biggest thing that's going to get punished unless they can get back onto Steve again if he overextends, but what it does mean is it gives Roccat the ability to push up to that tower. Elements are doing the same in the bottom lane. Janna Lucian is going to push towers pretty quickly, just in general.
But luckily for Roccat, they've got a four-man stack pushing top.
Yeah.
So it's two members of Elements in the bottom lane, four members of Roccat in the top lane. And we've got PvE League of Legends for the first couple of minutes here, Stress.
Yeah, we have. One thing that, as this game goes on further, could be problematic for Elements is whenever you're running Lucian Janna, it means you don't have any primary engage coming for your support. You're running a disengage support. It means that somebody else has to engage for you, which Steve theoretically can do. He obviously is on the Poppy, can get that charge in, utilize the ultimate as well. Gilius does have pick potential, but it's all fairly difficult engage to get off. It's not the likes of an Alistar that we've seen from the support role. We've seen a lot of Malphite the last couple of days. So Elements have to pick and choose their fights. It can be very difficult to balance it. Otherwise, they have to just back away, reset, and utilize their composition in slightly different ways, looking at maybe multi-lane control.
Luckily for Elements, they have a lot of tools to back away and reset.
Yes.
Yep. Janna, Viktor, defensive gravity fields. You know, if all else fails, just put down the verdict. Steve will say, get out of here. So there are tools there. For Roccat, though, I think they do have some tools. Fredy, if he does go a DPS item, should be able to do relatively well in playing the side lane game, put some split-push pressure down. We've seen it happen multiple times when Trundle was played top.
Yeah, that's the thing is, like, Trundle is so deceptive when it comes to his ability to 1v1. Subjugate, once he uses it, just means he's just almost always going to win a trade. The Trundle Poppy matchup isn't one I've got a massive amount of experience in competitive seeing it, so I'm trying to, like, look at where the tipping point is in this matchup for Fredy, but it's kind of almost inevitable that he is going to be able to take on Steve later into this game. The problem for him right now is Steve is up on experience, Steve is up on farm. Right now the game is just going better for Steve, regardless of having his flash burned earlier.
And it actually all stems back to those early decisions from Elements in the lane swap. They were just a couple steps ahead.
Yep.
It gave Steve just a few extra minutes in a lane, and despite being ganked somewhat awkwardly by Roccat, he's been able to build up this small lead. Fredy now has to deal with Rawls solo, and all the vision in the top quadrant of the jungle means Rawls is basically completely safe.
Yeah, for as long as the rest of Roccat are showing in lanes and not moving through that top side jungle, the only person they have to really keep track of is Airwaks on Kindred, who was down in the bottom side. They don't really have a read on where he is right now. That's the only person that could potentially spoil Mr. Rawls' fun here, pushing up towards the turret, but with a new wave joining, Mr. Rawls will reassess the situation, see what he thinks about the bottom side as well. But if Fredy ever does manage to group here with the team as this gets later, he can put down that pillar. It's obviously going to facilitate the Corki. It's been talked about so much. The same with the Braum Q. Just makes all of these skill shots so much easier to land.
See if they're on the same page. Because, of course, for Roccat, technically this is a very fresh duo lane. Extinkt coming in, I think, 2 weeks ago. Three maybe. Tabzz coming in even more recently. And they seem to be playing better, but when it comes to those bigger team calls and team decisions, Roccat's still trying to find their footing, find their identity, is something that has been said a few times about the team. I think it's a fair assessment, discovering where their strengths and weaknesses lie.
It's very much so. What we see in just the spring split in general is a lot of this feeling out period, because yes, there is championship points on the line. Yes, there's the spot at MSI. But for a lot of the teams that aren't looking right at that number one spot, there's a lot of kind of figuring out who you are as a team, your team identity. What exactly are you looking for out of the game, your strategy? And for Elements, when we took a look at the jungle gravity this week, for Element seems to be just, let's get EIKA ahead. He seems to be doing very well, and whether it's causation or correlation, you know, 3 minutes, and I believe it's just over 3 minutes on the jungle gravity for EIKA being spent in that mid lane from Gilius, and that's pretty high. I believe it's the highest of all mid lane and jungle combos. So that seems to be the Element's identity for right now. I just wonder whether that's going to work for them, because they're only one win on the board.
Yeah, unfortunately. We'll see how they bounce back. Luckily for Elements, playing a team that's also struggling, Roccat. And we've got that slower pace. This is somewhat what we were expecting from these team comps. They do want to scale up. They do want to get their items. And it's going to come down to who's going to put some pressure and some vision in their side lane.
Of course, apologies on that. That, of course, is Roccat.
1-8 for Roccat.
Yeah, it's all good. And the jungle gravity point. So that one was butchered by me. Don't worry, it's all good. We'll get to that at some point.
Yeah, and of course, those gravity stats are primarily focused on non-lane swap games, where the jungle actually has to decide which lane they want to help out. This time around, it was which tower do we want to knock over, as was the case. 2 towers to 2. And you can see Elements, they go, well, there's one more tower outside, Stress. I think we're going to go stand in front of it and siege.
Yeah, this isn't really the kind of gank that you ever want to attempt to see here. With a Janna trying to come out behind the turret, trying to look for the tornado against the Lulu, it's really not going to happen. Lulu, one of the most difficult lanes to actually kill from gank, especially post six. Level 9, and this is the first time we're really seeing it.
Luckily for Elements, they did get a lot of damage onto that outer turret. Yeah, it's real distracting, dude. Clicking.
It sounds like you ever seen those Western films where they just have that as a sound effect.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah, does the close
just before,
zoom in.
Just before they're there.
Oh, okay. I think you just killed headphone users. I'm sorry. Trevor just killed your ears. I'm really sorry.
I was waiting for the showdown. Steve and Freddy.
We're not
staring each other in the eyes. And then they walked away. And interestingly, Freddy, thanks to the lane swap, the freeze in that top lane, he's now the one that's actually got a 16-17 CS advantage.
He is right now. And normally you get punished for freezing right now in the current meta game. Normally it results in getting cross-map fairly often. Neither team really feels confident enough to push forward, and that is going to become quite a big problem, actually, when you look at these kind of compositions, is Elements are going to struggle to engage. Roccat need to siege, which means they need to have the ability to kind of 4-1. And they're not getting it.
Nope.
they're building time. They're not at that point yet. They're waiting for Tabzz to really get the Triforce, waiting for Freddy to be able to sit in that 1v1 comfortably. They haven't really tested that yet. So for Roccat, it is a waiting game, but it's been a very tempered, very patient game.
Yeah, you could sort of say the same for Elements, right? Viktor really wants to get some items, like Solution, etc. So, we'll see what's going to be the first testing point, maybe, for these teams. Eric's going to get a stack on that Kindred passive. And Freddy going towards what appears to be the Iceborne Gauntlet as a first item. So, I kind of feel like both of these teams are just trying to figure out where a weakness is in their opponent's play, and then they're going to try to exploit it. With only one blue trinket and two sweepers, not for Elements, that's the first change in the trinket approach, actually just equaled by Betsy as well.
Yeah, just equaled. I hope we don't end up in a Fnatic situation from earlier, but EIKA maybe caught out here, forced to flash very early.
Oh, there could be a stun coming out. Flashes forward from both Airwaks and Extinkt. EIKA will go down. Extinkt and Airwaks, they just punish him for being a little too far forward.
Yeah, this time Airwaks didn't need Betsy around in that middle lane, unlike as we have seen a lot from Roccat. This time it was just Extinkt and Airwaks with that Kindred having a lot of damage.
Yeah, a whole lot. Reminder to everybody at home, we are on 6-2. Those Dragon and Baron timers are on break at the moment. And Dragon will be up in about a minute and a half.
I'm going to give it another go, Trevor. Did you know, Trevor?
Okay.
Roccat normally have Airwaks middle lane a lot. They actually have the highest jungle gravity with mid and jungle combos out of every team in the EU LCS. Just over 3 minutes.
That is a lot of time.
You'd never have heard that before.
No, right? I really wouldn't have. But
that time is right.
The interesting thing about that jungle gravity that we started talking about, we're gonna be talking about more. That's tracking from 3 minutes to 15.
Yes.
Right. So it's just really looking at the laning phase. We're looking at why and where does a jungler go, and trying to put some numbers to it. 3 minutes out of 12 within 2,000 range. It is a massive amount of time.
Don't do too much math. We had a situation yesterday that didn't go so well with math on cast.
This one I know is golden.
Okay.
So this one is golden. Stats Bender gave us the numbers. I didn't really know where I was going to go with that.
No, I didn't know.
I just wanted to say Stats Bender. Just exciting calling spells and Stats Bender. Avatar ain't got nothing on him. Right, so Aram in the mid lane again. Outer turret standing. Elements have got decent vision in the blue side jungle of Roccat and actually some flank opportunities. Betsy steps maybe a little too far for the death ray and a siphon power. Means Betsy's forced back.
Held his nerve though, still has the ultimate available. Had the read on that, didn't feel like he was dying anytime soon, so I was waiting for that snap reaction. Roccat do have themselves a lead though, mainly off that first blood plus a little bit of farming time, but Elements want to siege up mid.
That has to be the tower. Extinkt eats a cocoon. Unbreakable Will comes up and the tower's being forced down. 30% of its hit points, the minion wave slowly being chipped away. Elements, they are making the aggressive move forward, and they are very close to securing that tower. Dragon has just spawned, though.
They're close. They forced Betsy away, but it wasn't enough. Betsy didn't even look to teleport to another lane. He just is going to hold that, make sure he's got the global presence around Elements. While they've taken the Dragon, Roccat don't really have too much on the map to do right now. It was shoved up far too far in the top side. Betsy was clearing out the bottom lane, and the rest of Roccat just kind of repositioned. Purchase some new items and back themselves away.
Well, we have to actually look at these team comps and say, well, what does Roccat want to do to win here? They kind of want Fredy to split push. They've got decent wave clear between Lulu and Corki. Their siege is okay, but I like some of the threat that Elements can bring because their wave clear and their ability to maybe tower dive with a cocoon and Poppy, etc. It feels like there's more tools for Elements to use. And they are the ones playing in the front foot. They are the ones trying to dictate the pace.
Yeah, they certainly are trying to dictate the pace right now. It is tough, though, with this fairly disengaged bot lane from Elements. They will obviously have a lot of presence here and a lot of safety on their carries, but we're finally seeing perhaps the 1v1 come out from Fredy. Fredy landed the pillar there. Does have Extinkt to follow up in that top side.
Unfortunately, Betsy wants to play with MRRallez, and you can see in the minimap that the top lane engage is where all the party is. The observers are 100% confident drama's happening here, though, because Gilius is now moving in. The wild growth used very, very early. Glitzerlance to slow Gilius down.
Rawls
is running out of mana, and the cancellation from Fredy or the interrupt, we'll have to find out later. Betsy eats a cocoon. Red buff is ticking from Gilius. The slow for slow. Flash forward. Gilius is trying to sink those Envenom fangs in, and he does finish up the kill. Elements are on the board.
Yeah, it was the interrupt onto Freddy's teleport there, so he wasn't able to join. And obviously, Betsy didn't have the read on that. That is now even on this. And Betsy was pushing up pretty far there into MRRallez. I think he thought he had enough safety because of how the rest of his team were moving on the map. They'd spotted a whole lot of people on top side, but they didn't have the read on the jungler. There was the block. Results in Betsy not being able to get away Gilius with the minion taxi. Enough.
Just a tad early on that little onset field. Spider got
Freddy's gone.
Back to life, and there we go. He is in fact gone. Gilius was looking for Airwaks. Airwaks had already used Lamb's Respite. Wasn't able to save his life. So now Elements, 1,000 gold down. They've got themselves two kills, and again, gonna set their sights on this outer turret.
Yeah, they're setting their sights on it, but this time there's Corki, there is the Lulu as well, so they will be able to clear that one out. Not an easy push here mid lane from Elements. They're trying time and time again, but really the guy that's getting a lot of work done is on the side lanes. It's MRRallez that's pushing up. Even without any kind of ability to cross between lanes, he's just soaking up enough attention from Roccat to push out the lane, force somebody to come up and deal with it, and then Elements look to push. Haven't had a whole lot of success. They got that pick from that happening. Problem is, Roccat are running double TP, so there's always going to be somebody available realistically to go over and clear that wave. So are elements. We just haven't really seen it, but we have seen today this really weird reversion to double TP. We saw it drop off completely at preseason because of the changes from teleporting to towers no longer giving you that shorter cooldown on TP. But there's just been less fighting mid lane.
Well, there
has been in theory.
Elements are finally going to take this tower down on their third real attempt. The zoning ultimate coming out from Steve. And of course, because he didn't fire the projectile, look how short that cooldown is. It'll be back up for a potential defense of this outer turret. Freddy also has no teleports available, so he cannot join in the fight if it were to break out.
That zoning ultimate is one of the funniest things we see, because it just feels like there should be just a projectile to follow it. It's the same kind of thing with the... Like, I've been playing Jin recently, and I just get the compulsion to finish his ultimate. Regardless of the extra cool, lower cooldown you get for every shot you don't fire, it's the same with Poppy. I'm like, oh, come on, I used all this time spinning up my ult. Let me at least use it. And then you realize, actually, the cooldown's significant.
Oh, yeah.
You shouldn't do that.
Well, there's a reason that those that can't do teach.
Well, why are we here? Steve is in trouble.
He's going to get chunked out. Throws down that hammer thanks to the shorter cooldown. Pins Airwaks against the wall. Might find himself one kill back. Airwaks was unable to get the respite, and Steve survives.
Steve survives off the shields. Manages to get SPRATTEL in just in time. And Airwaks just went under the tower, couldn't stay alive. Was his ult not available at the beginning of that?
I think it was just pinned and then got knocked back.
Got it.
Yeah, I think so. We'll catch a glimpse in a moment. Dragon will be respawning in a little less than a minute, Stress. So, Elements and Roccat both at one apiece to position themselves. So we can get a second look at this.
Keep a look at the ult timer from Airwaks. So it's coming up, but it's a while away. It's like a good 5 to 10 seconds away. So when aggressive, now it's up. So a little bit of a missed time by Airwaks results in giving another kill to Steven. That'll make Freddy say, oh man, that makes my lane that little bit tougher for the next few minutes. But nevertheless, Freddy is up to two items now. Has the Sunfire King, has the Iceborne Gauntlet. So that's the I'm just going to burn you to death with ice build. That means you just walk next to somebody and burn them to death. It's kind of a frustrating thing to play against.
Oh yes, especially with all of the other tools that Freddy can play with. The Pella, the Chomp. Stats stealing.
It's the same for Steve as well. He's got the same build. Same build we always see on Poppy. So they're just going to stand next to each other, let their clothing do the majority of the work. Of course, both of them have a lot of empowered auto attacks in the mix here as well. Just under a minute until Dragon coming up. And in fact, it's up.
Yep.
So the
information feed here is a little lacking, Stress. So we're relying on production to give us those dragon
attacks. It's okay, man. I'm still reeling after the jungle grab.
It's 10 minutes ago. You can move on. We do take stock of the situation, and it's even on gold. 500 separates. Two kills more for Elements. However, Roccat are grouping up in this middle lane, and EIKA, he's out for blood. Chaos Storm comes down. Will chunk Tabzz out a good teleport in from behind. Steve is going to pin Extinkt against the wall. Glacial Fish has already been used. A defensive flash,
good
but
flash.
The Spooky Ghost is going to find Extinkt. The verdict is wound up, and it will fall short. Extinkt survives another day.
Whoever wields this hammer shall apparently get out of the team fight alive there. Or... the likes of
Airwaks, what are you doing, my friend? You've denied the minion wave, maybe trying to alleviate the pressure on the inner turret. But now he's given up his flash and a kill to EIKA. Eventually.
There we go.
Eventually a kill to EIKA. Weird decision making, but it has allowed Roccat to defend middle and Freddy to push out bottom.
And Freddy pushing out down in that bottom side is the key, really, for Roccat. They need somebody to be able just push Steve back, push Rallez back whenever he's trying these flip push moves. And then it leaves Elements in a really awkward situation where they're relying on a binding, a cocoon from Gilius. If Steve isn't there to engage fights, Elements can't really fight. Such a tough, tricky spot to be in. And that duel's gonna take a while, because unless Freddy chooses to use his ultimate, they're going nowhere.
Yeah. It's gonna be gigantic wet noodle fight for a long time. But Elements, they are holding steady and still maintaining some semblance of control. Still holding onto their outer turret in that middle lane and gaining all the power that they need to theoretically start sieging, because Roccat actually have not done a siege. We'll expand on that in a second. Airwaks is going to use the Dance of Arrows away. No respite available. And 1 and 3 shaping his head on the player cam.
Airwaks is having a rough game here. Like, he keeps either getting caught out or not having his ultimate available when they're trying to make plays. And that's one of the real kind of weaknesses of a Kindred, is if you catch her without her ultimate up, she's very squishy. They die very, very quickly.
Yeah, that's definitely the case. And of course, this game was a lane swap.
Yeah.
Traditionally, Airwaks has camped for Betsy to get him ahead of his lane opponent. And because there was no ability to do that for Airwaks, Betsy's falling behind. He's down in CS. He's 0-1-0. He's playing a supportive champion. So, yes, maybe that's also something you have to factor in. But for a guy that's had statistics that are very impressive all split long in the early game, it is a difference. This matchup.
How are they not tired?
I have no idea.
I
love it that the observers are full on trolling. You guys have to come to the show. It's such a good vibe. So, Roccat, they're deciding to attempt the siege here. Teleport's available for Fredy. It is not
here
for
Steve. Michael, though.
There is Steve coming in from the side. Airwaks stunned. Airwaks is in trouble. The respite goes down as Betsy's knocked into the air. Wild throw is used just to keep Betsy alive. And Freddy's TP'd into the middle of Elements, but he's not tanky enough to survive it all. The Chaos Storm takes Betsy down, and Roccat are running for their lives. They will not fight. Live another day. Elements continue to push down in a turret, and at 25 minutes, Baron is up. That seems to be the target. Look at all the pings.
Man, there are some really weird situations for Roccat in this game. Airwaks eats the entirety of the culling. Betsy goes in on pretty much on his own onto EIKA, and EIKA just stands there and replies with the damage. From there, Elements are now disabled to take this Baron. Is there the potential for a steal from Airwaks? He's still in the base right now, so the answer to that is going to be no. And this is Elements taking that first Baron of the day.
That's it. 25 minutes. After clean team fight, punishing Roccat. And that's kind of what I was talking about a little bit while ago in terms of the team compositions. The tools available to Elements just feel like they synergize better. And here's that replay.
So this is all from Roccat's push. And look, Roccat are pushing with fairly limited vision right now. So one of the real key things about stepping up to your opponent's turret, especially when they have a Viktor, is you need to be able to see what is around the turret. They did not see Steve coming up into the fight. And it means Roccat had to back away. They couldn't kite back effectively against the culling. They just had to eat it. And then Elements caught up for the rest of the fight. And it's just Roccat trying to run and skipping steps at the same time.
Yeah, not working out for them. Dragon will be up in about 1 minute, we hope.
I was going to say, sure.
That one's better. And of course, we could see the Baron power play graphic on screen. Blue side, Elements secured it. 2 minutes remaining. Nobody's running Runic Affinity. That's what that +00 means.
Yeah, one game we're going to have something that isn't +00.
One of those days will happen. And of course, the gold difference that Elements have earned more than their opponents, Roccat, currently sitting at 1750.
We need an active Steve counter. That's what we need. Plus 1800 Steves.
Yes, exactly.
Feels like there's been about 1800 in this game, I'm not gonna lie.
It does indeed. But Elements, they've grouped up effectively.
Oh, no! Stop it.
I don't know what's available for Steve, and he's pushing the wave straight.
Okay. I'm gonna hazard a guess and say that is Strike. Our observers having a lot of fun.
They certainly are. And Elements, they're setting themselves up well. Remember, Elements were 3-6 coming into today. They lost to Fnatic yesterday. And they're looking to pick up another win here against Roccat. They have all the tools to make it happen.
Oh, Betsy's in trouble. He's got caught, forced to use his ultimate as well. Roccat having to back all the way away from this turret.
And they have done so. They're on the inner turret. Steve is winding up the verdict that will not manage to find a target, though. Glacial Fissure comes out to delay Elements. A defensive flash from Steve, and Roccat seem to be holding. Elements have used a lot of tools to try and break into the base, but it hasn't worked on this attempt.
Hasn't worked this attempt, but they're going to go for attempt number two. They have just used the Janna ultimate to heal up as well, so they are looking for siege number two. 4,000 positive is the Baron power play that's active.
And there's not a lot of ultimates left. Freddy was caught. Airwaks continues to play defensively. Respite and Flasher available. He's going to need to use it shortly. Airwaks goes forward, puts down Lambda Spreaders, stunned against the wall. Flashes only to die. Where did you think you were going to go? Roccat now running backwards as Elements. I'm going to take the first inhibitor of the game just as Baron pays off. 5K, the power play, and an inhibitor.
This has been a really rough game for Roccat. From the early lane swap, that just Elements were ahead of the playoff, a bit of an unorthodox setup from the jungle and top lane. Elements have been in full control for the entire game since. Roccat has never really been able to get the ball rolling. Freddy hasn't ever been able to really split push against Steve, and when he has, there's always been somebody else around. So Elements have just been able to play out this game better than Roccat have, but both of them have been fairly stalled out.
You step back from the game.
Oh dear.
You know, if you step back from the game and you look at the bigger picture here, Stress.
Yeah.
Elements have beaten Splice, have beaten Giants, have beaten Roccat. They're on the verge of going 2-0 against Roccat. They are the perfect number 7 team because they've clearly shown they're stronger than the weaker squads below them, and they're struggling against some of the teams above them. I'm trying to be serious.
It's okay. I'm just inside. I'm like, they're still struggling a little in this game, but they're not. They're actually doing better than Roccat. What you're saying is true here is they are able to just move around the map faster than Roccat. This time, maybe they can get the engage again. Airwaks is chunked out.
He really is. He needs to use that Lamb's Rest, but if he wants to try and save the world from devastation, I don't think it's going to work. EIKA, the Monsoon, ooh, will not be able to heal him back up. Now Extinkt and Freddy, they feel they might find an opportunity. Wild Growth was used on Tabzz and Roccat. They defend the inner turret.
They defend it because seemingly the Steve signal wasn't in the sky. No teleport came out. There we go. He's busy all the way up in the top lane trying to push a tower, but what was the cost on the bottom side? Looks like there's another little skirmish going on down. Freddy's trying to hold three people.
Mr. Riles takes a couple of tower shots. Freddy's able to thwart the pressure. Around a minute and 40 until the next Baron is up. And Elements are continuing to put pressure on multiple lanes. Roccat, they hold for now, but it was cutting it very, very close.
Yeah, cutting it really close. Airwaks holding off this mid lane as well. So Roccat, they, I believe, are going to be... well, they don't have that much gold on. I was thinking maybe they have a lot of gold extra, but of course they recalled after the Baron. So for Elements, kind of just resetting, looking for that next Baron of the game, setting up the vision control, going to try and get it, but they're competing with four blue trinkets, which means the Baron bait ain't going to happen.
Very, very difficult. And it's actually interesting if you think that we're 31 minutes into the game. That's not actually incredibly late. But we've had large periods of low activity, and the previous Baron is what really opened the game up for Elements. About 50 seconds before it spawns, hence the reason both Elements and Roccat are grouping up around the objective. I'm looking at pink wards, 1, 2. I count 3 in Elements' back pockets. Roccat currently got 2, and those trinkets will become available shortly. So, Vision and Baron Dance?
No, that's Freddy. That's Freddy. It's not Steve.
Well, that's Airwaks finding EIKA. And a jump backwards. Extinkt Unbreakable will keep him alive for a few more seconds. Airwaks completely says, your problem, bro. Does not use Lamb's Respite. Continues to run away. Going to put it down, I believe, shortly. Steve jumps forward onto Airwaks. Has used the Keeper's Verdict to knock away Tabzz. 3 members of Roccat are running. And a long range dash. Steve jumps onto the back line. Tabzz was killed over by EIKA in the mid. And Freddy's running for his life. The last remaining member of Roccat. He cannot protect the world from devastation. He's knocked away, and Elements are going to close out this game. Pushing down Steve with a gigantic smile on his face. Elements win a convincing team fight, and in 33 minutes, take down Roccat.